party started, y'all. This is a Fatback party, y'all. Is this your first time here? Let me see the first timers. First timers. That's good, that's good. The old timers are gonna show you what to do. They're gonna tell you what to do. Cause we don't stop. We just party right on through the night. Are you ready? Are you ready? All right, y'all. All right, y'all.
Working musicians.
I was producing when I started the band. I was producing and recording. I was a recording musician in New York. I was doing sessions and stuff like that. I decided to put a band because I was playing with another band. Ron Anderson at the time, and then during the day I was doing recordings, a few recordings, wasn't doing that many, but then I started producing a few of my own labor. I had my Fatback label, and I produced a couple acts. Matter of fact, I did Mary Davis, one of her first recording, and I had a group called the Puzzles, and then I did a couple of things on, I think I did one on Johnny King too, but that's how I started out.
Was it always your intention to be a musician? From?
Oh yeah, I haven't done anything else but play music in life.
So it's been good for you?
Yeah, music has been good, you know, and then I get an attitude when I see people abusing it, and music and everything, because music has been my life.
Which way would you see as there's abusive behavior of music, or would you say that is when?
Well, I call abuse of music when you half do it, when you half play. If you're going to be a musician, you got to do your homework and put in the time, do your art. And then when you see musicians that want to be musicians, things like that, that's abuse to me of music, of being. You know, those wannabes, you know, think that you can just jump out and start playing, man, and going, you know, that's not what music is about. Music is a craft. You have to put in your time, you have to study it, and you have to go to school for music, just like anything else. You have to go, you know, some people are gifted and don't have to, study. But it always helps to study.
Yeah. And those people were gifted. Who were the musicians that influenced you in your youth, in your younger days?
Oh, some of the musicians that was my influence was a lot of the old-timers. My first influence was a friend of my mother's who used to come by and play the piano. My mother always had a piano in her house. She plays piano, and she studied and she wanted to be a pianist. And she, the first thing she did when she got a house was to buy a piano. And she had a boyfriend that came by and played. That's how I got interested in music. And he had a buddy that came by and he was a drummer. Mm. And he didn't have no drums. He would come by and play on paper books and with his mouth while my friend played piano. You know, he'd pa 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 while they'd be playing, and I thought that was exciting. That was my first influence, but some of the musicians that came through my town was a band called Buddy Johnson. They had a drummer named Foots in there. Well, I was fascinated with Foots. It was one of my first heroes. Then all the bands that came through my hometown. My hometown was a kind of mecca for musicians and entertainers because they came through there in the early days. And I got a chance to see all the greats.
That's good. That's important, isn't it, for when you actually want to make those steps towards being a real musician yourself, then you have those, you've seen how they do those things.
Yeah. Well, you know, the musicians that came up with, you know, the musicians that came in my life was they was the clean cut musicians. They look like doctors and they dress, you know, they're not the musician breed of the today musician, you know.
Yeah.
coming on stage with the, you know, the dungarees and that kind of stuff. Those the musicians of the days were the clean cut cats, man. Yeah. And most of them, the laymans and would look at the musician to see what did, what fad, what style was in style, and they wanted to dress like them. Yeah. But a musician was they was leaders, man, in the neighborhood.
They were highly respected people.
Yeah. But they didn't get respect from older people because they would, first thing that older people would tell you, you don't want to be no musician because you're not going to make no money, and plus all musicians are drunks and drug addicts. Yeah, I don't want my son doing that. But musicians, you know, after the musicians that I was around, and they was all businessmen, man. One of my guy that taught me the business and showed me the ropes was Paul Williams. The Huckabuck man. I went out with him. That's what I got my training with. And then I was out with some other musicians that I worked with, showed me how I wouldn't want to treat musicians. They showed me I don't want to go this way. They treated the musician, band leaders treated musicians terrible. But then you had band leaders like Paul Williams and Bill Doggett and the cats like those that, hey man, they took care of their men. They took care of the cats and they paid well and they treated them well.
So there was a kind of mutual respect.
So when I saw how they were treating their musicians and things, man, I said, oh, hey, I know how to treat my guys when I get me a band.
We are getting, in the last 10 years, I've gotten more play on my music than we ever had before. Yeah.
Because time is just catching up with us. We were so far in front of the game. See, everybody was into a different style of music when I was coming along, the disco and all that different type of thing. And we just made a few disco records, and then we slept, went on to something else. Mm. Then we did the first rap thing. Mm-hmm. Then we went on to something else. Then we went on to the fun thing. Cause we always keep going. We kept building. You can listen to the albums that we made and listen to the growth of the band, how our music would change. The music would change when we first started, and you listen to our the gap like going home to see my baby. Mm. Then you listen to the music like, is this the future? Mm. There's a whole different
sound.
Yeah, the whole different style and a whole different sound in that. And a lot of people ask me, Bill, since you was going on with the rap, why didn't you make more raps? Yeah. Well, I didn't think rap was going to be, I thought it was a fad.
Oh.
You know, I never knew, felt like rap was going to be as big as it was.
Yeah.
And but it happened that cats like Russell Simmons kept it alive.
Yeah.
And kept building on it, and then they found a whole generation who dug it, and it took off.
Yeah.
And if you told me 10 years ago, back there when the 90s or the 70s, that the rap would still be around, I would have told you, no way.
Really?
Because music has a 10-year period.
Yeah.
Music goes through a whole cycle. Every 10 years it changes.
That's right. There's a decade.
Yeah, a decade. That's all music it works. And your musicians and entertainers have a short run too. Only a few of them go past that 10-year period.
Yeah.
You got a 10. So you got to get everything done in that little 10 years.
Squeeze
man.
It in.
Yeah, you got to squeeze it in there, man.
So what's the future hold?
Hey man,
what comes after this?
Well,
we land on the moon.
Well, listen. You have to do your homework. You got to see. Today, musician, I tell my cats, you can't be good. You got to be great.
Yeah.
And you can't follow. See, this generation of kids like to be followers. They want to be in the mix with everybody. You can't, if you want to be a good entertainer of music, you got to bring something new to the table. But you got to be great. And you got to do your homework. You got to put in the time. You got to make your audience. You got to build your audience. You got to go out in the field and gather them up and get some from here, get some from there, and you sell them your music, and you use your record and your music as a calling card. Give them the music as a calling card nowadays to come to. And then, you build that audience, and when you start playing, coming out on the road, you got your audience to play to.
They're waiting for you.
Yeah. But you got to build them up. You got to go out in the field and build it up. So this is what
we've achieved a lot through the music. I mean, the world has changed incredibly because of black music. The music of sun-kissed people.
Oh, I tell when I first came over here, they didn't have black bands playing out here. And as I come over years and years, you'll find bands playing like the Fatback, building their band like, now you got, they got all kind of R&B bands sounding like Fatback now. But when I first came up, they didn't have that here yet. And I tell guys, quiet as it kept, guys, y'all got your style from me.
Yeah, no doubt. Well, you got the respect.
Oh, listen, I was glad to do it, man. I'm glad. See, I tell people, the greatest thing is to see somebody imitating you, man. That's the greatest thing in the world. I love to see that. I say, hey, man, go ahead.
Try your best.
Yeah, do your best. I know that when I see them imitating Fatback, I know we must be on the right track.
Yeah.
But must have a little something. I don't know what it is we got, but we must have a little something.